Okay, let's start the concept of pointers and structures. Because when you are going to create a linked list or you have to perform any kind of operations over a linked list, first you have to create the nodes by using the self-referential structure. For that, you need the pointer concept. Okay, so first of all, we have to be clear on what is pointer, how to declare a pointer. Okay, basics only I'll discuss that is needed for the linked list chapter, linked list portion. So first, so the pointer, basically you need pointer because C is the most powerful language due to the concept of pointer. Okay, because by a pointer is nothing but it is holding some address. So you are basically working with the machine, very close to the machine level instructions, right? So what is the application of pointer? Basically, pointers are used to access array elements . So my screen, whatever I'm writing on the screen, it is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So basically pointers are used to access the array elements. Okay. Also, suppose when you have to do some dynamic memory allocation. Pointers are also used. So now you are going to learn for the implementation of data structures like linked list, tree, graph, stack and queue. Pointers are also used. Okay, so first we have to know what is pointer. Okay, you have to know what is pointer and how to declare a pointer, how to initialize a pointer, all these things. So first of all, before understanding how the memory, how the pointers are working of pointers, we have to first know what is the concept of memory. Okay, when you are writing any program, okay, so first it is first loaded in the primary memory. Your memory is nothing but how the memory is organized. Suppose it is organized in 1D array representation. For example, you have the memory of 1 KB. You have the RAM of 1 KB. For the understanding purpose, for the explanation purpose, better explanation, I'm taking the memory size equal to 1 KB. Okay, that means, so this is my memory. Each block is of 1 byte. Okay, so all the blocks are assigned with some address. For example, the initial address equal to 0, second address equal to 1, third address equal to 2, and so on. Okay, last address, then what is the address of the last cell?
N-1.
N, what is that N-1? My size, already I'm giving the size of the memory equal to 1 KB. 1 KB equal to how many bytes? 999. 1024 bytes. Okay, this is nothing but 1 byte. Each cell, suppose I'm taking my word size equal to 1 byte, each cell is occupying 1 byte. Okay, so now last index equal to 1023. Okay, last index equal to 1023. So all of you clear, this is my memory, right? So when I declare the variable int a, right, then what happened? What is the size of a? This is the keyword that is used, that is the operator that is used to find the size of any variable, size of any data type like this. If I write size of a, what I get?
4 bytes.
4 bytes. Very good. So you get 4 bytes. Okay. Size of the integer equal to 4 byte, right? That means, for example, when I write int a, so this is user friendly. You know a is of type integer. Okay. But internally, what happened? That variable a is stored in some memory location. It is stored in some memory location. For example, it is stored in the location starting address equal to 200, 201, 202, 203. Because it is going to occupy how many bytes of memory? 4 bytes of memory. Okay. So now internally this variable a is stored in this 4 bytes of memory. A is stored in the 4 bytes of memory. Right. If I write a equal to 5. If I write a equal to 5. Then how it is represented? So now a equal to 5. It is converted to binary. It is converted to binary. First, you have to do that. That machine, that compiler is going to convert it to binary. Right? And that binary representation is stored in these 4 bytes of memory. 4 bytes means total 32 bits. In 32 bits, the number A equal to 5 is stored in these 32 bits. Okay, that means 5 is nothing but 101. Okay, so rest, how many bytes? 29 bytes, 29 bits equal to 0. 29 zeros, then 101. It is nothing but 29 zeros, then after 101, it is represented as a equal to 5 and it is stored in the memory. Let the location equal to 200. Because my memory addresses are from 0, 1, 2 up to 1023. Okay. My variable a is stored in the location 200. All of you clear? This is the normal declaration of the variable. How the variable is declared normally. Okay, then you have to know what is the address of A. If I write, what is the address of A? If I print, what is the address of A? Who can say? What is the address of A? Jaldi batao.
200 is base.
200 or 201 or 202, 203. Which one?
200.
200. So it is going to represent initial address. It is going to represent the initial address from which address that variable is stored in the computer's memory. So address of A is equal to 200. Okay. So now, it's time. Actually, you have to already, you know, the basic variable. Now it's time to introduce the pointer. What is pointer? Pointer is a variable. Pointer is a variable, okay, that stores the memory address. From the basic, I'm explaining what is pointer, okay. So I stop the linked list portion, okay, because most of the students have doubt actually how that working of the pointer and structure. So first I'm explaining what is pointer basic, okay, not I'm going towards the pointer arithmetic, all these things. What is pointer and how to declare pointer, how to declare memory dynamically. So pointer is a variable that holds the address, that holds the memory address, okay. Memory address of what? Memory address of?
Variable
memory address of array, memory of structure, memory address of class, etc. Okay, that means now this pointer is holding the memory address of another variable, memory address of array, memory address of structure, memory address of class. Okay, it is called pointer because it points to a particular location in memory by storing the address of that location. Okay, see here. Okay, so now you see here. So in this case, what happened? My A, the variable A is stored in the memory location 200, right? Suppose I declare a pointer. First of all, you have to know how to declare the pointer. How to declare the pointer? Okay. So the declaration of pointer is simply by writing data type star ptr name. Data type or asterisk or star, whatever you can say, that is data type star ptr name. PTR name. Okay. Suppose I write, then after semicolon, suppose I write int star ptr, float star ptr, like this. You can declare any pointer of any kind of data. That means now this ptr is a pointer that point to a memory location where the integer type of data is present. Okay. FPTR is a pointer. That means now you are going to declare like this. So this is a pointer, PTR. Okay. It is going to point to a memory location where integer value is present. Integer value means 4 bytes of memory is there. In that 4 bytes of memory, integer variable is present and PTR is holding the address of that location. For example, in the previous slide, already I said the variable A is stored in the memory location 200. So the value of PTR equal to 200. If I assign PTR equal to address of A. Okay. Similarly, if I write for the second type of declaration, I create a pointer, FPTR. Its name is FPTR. It holds the address of, it also, the floating point value is also 4 bytes of memory. Let the address equal to 300. So the content of FPTR equal to 300. So you can see here in this case. Okay. So in this case, you see now I declare a variable. The variable A is stored in the 200 memory location. If I write integer star ptr, okay, ptr equal to address of a. Now this pointer is a variable. That means now I can display, if I write address of ptr, this is a variable. So what is address of ptr? It is going to take some memory space. Okay, it is going to take some memory space in my 1D array. Let address of ptr equal to 2. Let 2. And it occupies 4 bytes of memory, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, because pointer is nothing but it is holding the address. It also occupies the size of the integer. The size of integer equal to 4 byte. So now address of PTR equal to 2. That means in the second memory location, my pointer variable PTR is stored. As it is a variable, it also occupies some memory space. Okay, it has some memory size, that is 4 byte. And the initial address of PTR equal to 2. All of you clear what is pointer variable and what is normal variable? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes, pointer ma'am. Variable, its content is some address. That means now PTR, the value of PTR equal to the value of PTR. If I write PTR equal to address of A, the value of PTR equal to 200. Okay. Because it contains the address of A. Then what is address of PTR? The address of PTR equal to 2. Because pointer is a variable, it also stored in some memory location. Let the memory location equal to 2. Okay. So the address of PTR equal to 2. Okay. So now what is dereferencing of pointer variable? This is C. Okay. So what is pointer variable? That pointer variable is basically written as, I'm giving the example, int asterisk ptr equal to address of A. right? That means pointer is now the content of pointer equal to the value of that address A. So what is dereferencing? Dereferencing means, that means now we have to access the value indirectly from that memory access. If I write A equal to printf A, then I get A equal to 5. Okay. Now I have to access the value of A equal to 5 by using this pointer. I have to access the value of A equal to 5 by using this pointer. And how to access? For that dereferencing operator, that is asterisk, is used. Okay. Don't be confused. Asterisk is used to declare a pointer. Asterisk is also used to dereference a pointer. Asterisk means it is value at that location. Value at location. Okay. That start symbol is basically used to display the value at the location. If I write asterisk of PTR, then what I get? Asterisk of PTR equal to?
5.
You can simply write printf A equal to 5. You can display printf percent D A. You get the value of A equal to 5. If I write printf percent D star of PTR or asterisk PTR, I also get the value of indirectly, not directly, because this is the pointer, the address equal to 200. It is pointing to a location where value 5 is present, right? So the address equal to 200 here, because this is the variable A. If I write asterisk of PTR, that means I'm going inside. I'm going inside that location. Okay, PTR means it is standing outside. Asterisk of PTR means I'm going inside that location. Inside that location, 5 is present. Okay. So simply this part is standing outside the cell. Standing outside the cell means it is going to display 200 as the address. Asterisk means you have to go inside that address. Inside that address, the value 5 is present. So this is called as the dereferencing of the pointer variable. Okay. So now, for example, just for the understanding, I take one example. Let int A equal to 87, for example. Float B, I take another variable. Float B equal to 4.5. Okay. So for my handwriting, all of you be clear with the handwriting. So int star PTN, int asterisk PTN. Is it clear na, my handwriting? Address of A. If I write float star PT, float star P2 equal to address of B. So I declare two pointers, right? One is the integer pointer, other is the floating point pointer, right? So now I write, what is the value of star of P2? Tell me what is the value of star of P2? What is star of P2? 4.5. You get the value at that location, 4.5. Because P2, it is the address of B. Address of B, the variable B. In that address, the value 4.5 is present. So star of P2, or it is the value at that address, or it is also called as the dereferencing operator, to know the value or the content at that address. Star of P2 equal to 4.5. So if I write star of P1 equal to 9, is it possible? Star of P1 equal to 9.
No.
Ma'am.
Can I write this type of assignment?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, I can't change. I can change. Already star of P1 means P1 is the address of A. Okay. So in that address, now I have to modify the value.
Yes.
I have to modify the value. The value equal to 87. Now I have to change to 9. It is possible. Okay. If I write star of P1 plus plus. For example, I write star of P1 plus plus. Then what is the output I'll get? Star of P1 plus plus. So forget this part. P1, the value equal to 87 here. Okay. Star of P1 plus plus. It is nothing but A plus plus. It is same as the A plus plus. Okay. It is same as A plus plus. What is the value of A? 87. 87 plus plus, you get 88. Okay. Incrementing the value at that location. Incrementing the value at that location. Okay. So that means if I write star of P1, asterisk P1, asterisk P2, it is equivalent to the value of A and P. If I write P1 and P2, so P1 and P2 are nothing but the address of A and P. It is equivalent to address of A, it is equivalent to address of B. So all of you clear? Okay. So let's do the program so that you will be clear. For example, you see that the editor is visible. Ha bolo.
Then yes, I'll push it.
Okay.
Yes,
so I here this program is going to display what is the size of all the kinds of data types. All the kinds of data types used in a C program. Okay. Character, integer, float, that size of operator is needed. Size of operator is needed to display how much byte that variable or the data type is going to take. Okay. So size of character. So before running the program, tell me what is the size of character?
One byte. Size of integer.
Four byte. Size of double. Eight byte. Okay. Very good. So let's run this program. So the size of character equal to 1 byte, integer 4, float 4, unsigned integer equal to 1. Okay, signed integer from minus 128 to 127, but unsigned integer it is from 0 to 255. Okay, signed character is also 1 byte, short integer 2 byte, unsigned integer 4 byte, double 8 byte, long double 12 byte, long integer it is 8 byte. So that means basically the size of operator, this operator is used to find out what is the size, how much memory that previous class already I said the structure member, how that structure member, how much byte it is occupied by the structure member. For that you can, instead of calculating manually, you can write the size of operator to display the number of bytes occupied by the variable or that member. Okay. So for that, take another program. So this one is C++ program. Suppose first line is hash include. For example, I write start P2. P2 is the floating point pointer. P2 equal to address of B. Okay, so I declare two pointers already that so printf. Suppose I have to display what is the address. Okay, in which address my variable is stored. The address. The address of A equal to. So for that I need %u, that specification, %u, that address of A. Okay. So now let's run this program. So what is the address of A? You see, what is the address of A? The address of A in my computer's memory is taking that address 2686724. Okay, 2686724. My memory that address number of that is, it is the 64-bit computer. So the memory address equal to 2686724. Okay, So this variable A is stored in this memory location. That means A is stored means first location is this part. Suppose this is X. So this is X. X equal to this one, 2, 6, 8, 6, 7, 2, 4. Second one is X plus 1, X plus 2, X plus 3. Now I have to find, I have to print what is the address, what is the value, what is the value of the address of P1. Okay, the address of P1. The address of P1. What is the address of P1? You can say. You can say because the P1, it is going to store in some memory location. So the address of P1 is also like, you can see the address of P1 is equal to 2, 6, 8, 6, 7, 20. Okay, so that means in this location the pointer variable P1 is stored. In this memory location the normal variable A is stored. Okay, because pointer is a variable, so it is stored. This pointer variable P1 is stored in this memory location. The normal variable is stored in this memory location A. Normal variable A is stored in this location. We get two different memory location. As pointer is a variable, it is going to also occupy some memory space in the computer's memory. Now it's time to dereference. Okay. Suppose the value of A. The value of A. The value of A equal to, as it is an integer, I write percent D. I write simply A. Okay. Also by writing asterisk of P1 also. Also, I am getting the value of A by writing asterisk of P1 also. Okay. Let's run this program. Okay, so put this slash in. See here. So what is the address of P1? This is the address of P1. Address of A, address of P1 are different. Then what is the value of A? If I write A equal to, if I display A, I get the value of A equal to 5. If I write asterisk of P1, I get the same value of A equal to 5. Okay. So now, in this way, I can also, then what is the, in this way, I can also access the floating point variable. I can also access the floating point variable. Now, what is the size? Size of both these pointers. Okay, what is the size of P1? What is the size of P2? If I have to display, what is the size of P1? That means, that is how much bytes that P1 and P2 are taking. The number of bytes P1 takes equal to percent D. How much byte it takes equal to percent D. So for that, I need the size of operator. Size of P1. Okay. Size of P1. So how much byte that P1 is going to take? How much byte that P1 is going to take? Bolo? The number of bytes P1 is going to take? 4 bytes. Okay, so if I have to dis 4 byte, because P1 is a pointer, integer pointer, any pointer, integer pointer, character pointer, float pointer, what is the size of that address? Size of that address is always the integer. As the integer occupies 4 byte, that pointer is also occupies 4 bytes of memory. The number of bytes P1 takes equal to 4 bytes. If I display, if I display the number of bytes P2 takes, the number of bytes P2 takes, then what is the size of P2? What is the output I'll get here? Bolo. What is the size of P2? What is the size of P2? The number of bytes P2 takes equal to 4 bytes. The number of bytes P2 takes is also 4 bytes. You see, the number of bytes P2 takes equal to 4. Okay. So, then what is the conclusion? The conclusion is whatever that character pointer, integer pointer, or float pointer, structure pointer, whatever the pointer, it is going to occupy size equal to size of the integer. Okay. So this is all about your pointer. All of you clear what is pointer? Pointer is nothing but it is going to hold the address of another variable. Till now I have explained this pointer is going to hold the address of any other variable. Okay. So now you have to know how to allocate memory dynamically. Before that you need the structure. You need structure. Okay. So struct, by the struct keyword, for example, a person. For any kind of person, you have different several information because you have to keep the record of a person. Every person have the details like name, have some address, okay, have some other number. Other number integer is not sufficient, for that you need long integer, other number. Okay, having some age, integer age. So to keep this type of information, array is not sufficient. You can create the array for name, array for address, array for other, array for age, but it is not okay when you have to maintain the information of 100 to 200 persons information. Array is not the good idea to represent the information by using the array. So for that you have to create a new kind of data type that is called as the user defined data type. So structure is one of them, class is also another one, union is also another one. So by using that you can create your own data type. So here the person is the name of the structure. So these are the members of the structure, right? So next thing is how to access the members of the structure. We can access the members of the structure by the dot operator. Okay, that means first I have to declare the variable struct person. Declare the variable p. P is the variable of this kind of data type. Now I write p dot. If I write p dot name, then I access the name member. I can also write p dot address. So dot operator is used to access the members of the structure. Okay. So if it is the normal variable, if it is the pointer variable. So first let me explain with an example. For example, I have structure. Okay, so this one is the structure. This is by using the dot operator. So now in this structure, I create a structure. The name of the structure is complex. In this complex, it has two parts, real part and imaginary part. Okay, now I declare the variables of this structure type. C1 and C2 are the variables of this structure type. The question is how to declare the variable. So struct keyword is needed. Struct, then the name of the structure, C1 and C2 are the variables of the structure. Okay, so now you have to give the input by the dot operator. You can see you can give the input by the dot operator. That is ampersand C1 dot real. When you have a structure, you can access the members by the dot operator. Okay, C1 is a variable, dot real. So you can give the input by the dot operator. The imaginary part also you can give this C1 dot imaginary. Okay, so dot operator is one way to give the input and display the members of a structure. Another way by the pointer. Another way is by the pointer. Okay, so this one. Another way is by using the pointer. So now another one is, what is the use of typedef? Typedef means, so what is the need of typedef? Suppose you have to do some redefining the data type. You have to just rename the existing data type. Okay, then typedef keyword is used. For a lengthy name, just to shorten it, you can use the typedef keyword. This is the keyword. So instead of struct complex, I write comp. This is the new name. If I write typedef int a, typedef int a, and what happened? Now my integer keyword, integer data type is renamed as the new name equal to A. So in this new name, I can create a variable one, variable two like this. Okay. So it is basically used if my structure, that name is very lengthy, I can just redefine it to a very small name. So now here I write, so instead of when I'm going to declare the variable, always, what? Okay, so when I have to declare the pointer of this structure type, here you see the structure name is C1P, this is the new data type. C1 and C2, these are the pointers for this structure type. So C1, this is the pointer. Then what is the address of this pointer? This pointer is going to hold the address of the normal variable A. Okay, C2 is a pointer. This holds the address of the normal variable B. Right, so now by the pointer, so here you can't access the member by the dot operator. To access the member, you need the arrow operator. So that is C1 arrow real. C1 arrow imaginary. Okay. So for that you have to need the arrow operator, as it is a pointer. To access the structure member, you need the arrow operator. If it is the normal variable by A, I can access A dot real. I can access A dot real. B dot real, but by the pointer variable, I have to use the arrow operator. Okay, I have to use the arrow operator. So to get the complex number, address of arrow C1 real, C1 imaginary. Okay, so this is all about your structure.
Ma'am, array operator will dynamically allocate, na?
That is dynamically allocated. Dynamically allocated means it is going to hold some address. It is going to hold some address. See here, what is the address of C1? C1 equal to address of A. Okay, C1 equal to address of A. That means pointer is always going to hold some address. What is that address? Address of A. So another way is also, you can also write, if I write instead of A and B, if I write C1 is equal to, okay, malloc size of, this is also okay. So you can also do in this way or in this way. You can do dynamic, this is dynamic allocation, or you can assign the normal variable's address to the pointer variable. Okay, so this is another way, this is dynamic allocation. Till now the variables A and D are not created, you are going to allocate memory for that structure pointer variable. Okay, so that means dynamically some memory is allocated, the address is assigned to C1. The address is assigned to C1. Otherwise, C1 equal to address of A. Already A variable is declared, and you have to assign the address of A to the variable, pointer variable C1. Okay. But this one is called is the dynamic allocation, and this one is not dynamic allocation. For dynamic allocation, malloc function is used. Okay. Next topic, I'm explaining what is dynamic allocation. You see here, this is very much important, how to allocate memory dynamically. That means dynamic memory allocation is basically needed. That is how much, instead of wastage of memory, instead of surplus of memory, you can assign memory according to your need. For that, you have to assign the memory at runtime. This is called as the dynamic memory allocation. Okay. So for that, malloc function is used. Malloc function is used. Malloc, calloc, realloc is used, but for the linked list chapter, you have to be used for the malloc function. So I'm explaining the syntax of the malloc function, right? So the syntax is basically malloc size of any data type, size of any data type, okay? Or I can give the size, okay? I can give the size. If I write malloc 10, malloc 10 means suppose I write pit year equal to malloc 10. That means now 10 byte is allocated. Okay, 10 byte inside the computer's memory, 10 bytes are allocated. The starting address, suppose it is 100. Okay, so after successful execution, 100 is assigned to the pointer variable pit year. Okay, malloc 10 means 10 byte is assigned. So I can also, suppose I have to store five integers. 5 integers means I can assign only 2 integers here. Rest 2 bytes are wasted. Okay. So that means now the room is allocated. Some memory space is allocated by the memory malloc function. By default, it returns void type. As it is a function, it returns void. It returns void. Okay. So for that, you need the type casting. If I have to store in this memory location any integer variable, I have to do the type casting. Okay. That means I have to do the type casting. So for that, you have to follow the syntax like ptr equal to int star malloc size of integer, size of int. See the syntax? Pointer, because this is the dynamic memory allocation, malloc function is used means it is dynamic memory allocation. When you are going to write this malloc function, if some memory is free, what is the size of integer? 4 byte. 4 byte is allocated. Okay, so this is just 4 bytes are allocated, but in these 4 bytes, which kind of data I have to store? For that I need type casting. For that I need type casting. If I write int star, that means in that memory location 201, 202, like this, 201, 2, 3, 4. So I store integer type of data. If I write float, if I write float star, size of float, then what happens? If I write float star malloc size of float, that means it is going to allocate 4 bytes of memory, but in that memory location, I can store the floating point variable. I can store the floating point variable. This is called as the type casting. Okay, type casting means some room is created. Suppose you have to go to any room that is for the renting purpose. Room is there, but that room is used for any, that is institution, that room is used for any coaching center, that room is used for any living purpose. Okay, so for that you need a type casting. Which type of thing you have to use for that purpose, that is called as the type casting. These 4 cells are blank. If I have to store the integer type of data, I need int star. Okay, the syntax is pointer variable is equal to data type star. I'm writing pointer variable is equal to data type star. Data type star malloc size of data type. Size of data type. Okay, so this is the syntax of malloc function. The data type may be integer, float, character. The data type may be what? Maybe structure type, the data type may be class type, anything. Right? So this is the syntax of the malloc function. Now what is linked list, what is self-referential structure, and how to allocate memory for a node? So what is self-referential structure? The self-referential structure is a structure, struct node. Okay, so inside the node I have 2 parts, suppose integer information part, struct node, link. I have 2 parts, one is the integer part, one is the link part. So you have to end the structure declaration by a semicolon. Okay, that means you are going to create a structure. In this structure you have, it has 2 parts, one is the information part, other part is the link part. Okay, that means it indicates that when it is going to store link, it is the pointer, right? Pointer means it holds some address. Which kind of address? It is pointing to an address. It is a pointer means it is going to reference to a pointer, that is reference to a memory location. In that location, you get the same type of structure, same type of model. That means same types of blueprint. Okay. That means in that template, one part is the information part, other part is the link part. So this is called as the self-referential structure. One member of the structure that is pointing to the same structure itself. Okay. So why it is needed in the linked list? Because linked list is the collection of nodes. Linked list is the collection of nodes. you have to create the nodes and link all the nodes one after other. Okay, so for creation of the nodes you have to allocate memory for the node. You have to allocate memory for that node, right? So what is the syntax? Suppose I have to allocate memory for this structure. What is the malloc function? Malloc function is struct node star ptr. Okay, so ptr equal to you have to do the typecasting, struct node star, okay, malloc size of struct node. Malloc size of struct node. Double bracket, then semicolon. Okay. So how to allocate memory for this node? Because node is a new data type, struct node, it is a new data type, or you can create the variables of this data type. Then how to allocate memory for this data type? You need the syntax. The syntax is ptr is the pointer variable. Ptr is the pointer variable of which type? Struct node type. That means this is the address. It is holding the address. In that address, which kind of data is present? A structure type of data is present. Okay. So here in this structure type, it has two part. One is the information part, other is the link part. Okay. So this is my pointer. Then you have to allocate the memory for this structure type. The syntax is ptr equal to struct node star, because you have to do the typecasting. In that memory location, I have to store the structure type information. So this is typecasting. Then malloc is the function. Then you have to allocate memory for this, for these two members. For these two members means first member is going to take 4 bytes of memory. Second member is going to take 4 bytes of memory. Already I explained every pointer is going to hold 4 bytes of memory. So this is the integer information. It also allocates 4 bytes of memory. Total 8 bytes are allocated. This malloc function successfully returns 8 bytes of memory and the initial address. Initial address, let it is x, anything, I don't know. So what is the value of x? This x is returned by this malloc function and it is stored in the pointer variable ptr. Okay, all of you clear? And out, bolo.
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt, bolo. Next. I will discuss how to create a node and how to do that linking, how to create a single linked list and how to do that linking part. Any doubt till now? Batao.
No, ma'am.
I need all of you have to be clear in the structure and pointer part. Structure means just what is self-referential structure and or how to declare a structure. Okay. Self-referential structure means one member of the structure is a pointer. Of which type? Same structure type. Okay, that's why I'm writing struct node star. Struct node is the structure type. Okay, so without typecasting, every time I have to write without typedef, I have to write struct node repeatedly. So for that, to avoid that, I have to use the typedef. Typedef means you have to redefining in data type. Okay, if I write typedef, see here, if I write typedef here. If I write type def struct node as capital node. Okay, so I declare a structure. The name of the structure is node. Okay, then I redefining that struct node, because every time this struct node is repeatedly written. So to avoid that one, I have to write the node. Okay, then how to modify my program? How to modify my program? So these two lines of code, I can modify it as simply instead of struct node, what I write? Node star ptr. Okay, then what is ptr? Ptr equal to node star malloc size of node. Node star malloc size of node. Okay, I'll write it again. So to avoid the writing of struct node number of times, just I'll write redefine a new name. The new name is node. Now I just write node star ptr. Star ptr is the pointer variable of the structure type. Now ptr equal to node star malloc size of node. Same syntax. Just now I redefine struct node as node size of node. Okay, so this is all about how to allocate memory for a node. After successful execution of this statement, you are going to create a node. So this is my node. Every node in the linked list has two part. One is the information part, one is the link part. Okay, then my task is how to assign the address in this link part. By assigning the address in this link part, I have to connect to the second node. By assigning the address in this link part, I have to connect to the next node of the linked list. So this is nothing but the connection of the nodes in the linked list, or it is called as the linked list. Now it's time for your doubt discussion. If you have any doubt, then tell me. Any doubt? Hello?
Yes.